Welcome to the step-by-step tutorial on how to load data using a flat file into Oracle Profitability and Cost Management Cloud. I'll be using data management. This tutorial is the second of a two-part series. Part 1 covers the following sections. Part 2 covers the following sections. Let's talk about period mappings. Period mappings are used to match calendar formats between the source and target system. My application uses the period and year dimensions for calendar mapping. Because I'll be loading into June 2016, I'll create a mapping that points to the June member of the period dimension and a 2016 member of the year dimension. Category mappings are used to map scenario dimension members between the source and target systems. Create an entry for each scenario you will be loading to. And if the scenario member names in our source and target systems do not match, you can create mappings in this section. For example, your source system may have a scenario called Current, which you want to map to the actual scenario in your target system. Let's move on to data load mappings. Data load mappings are used to define member mappings for each dimension in the target system. Before defining mappings, change the point of view entries to make sure we are loading from the correct source and target using the items we defined earlier. Select the location, period, and category you defined. The dimension dropdown lists dimensions you define in your import format. If your source and target members do not match, you can create data load mappings to instruct where these unmatched data should go. Remember to select the right dimension. Next, select a mapping type using the tabs. Then, add a row for each mapping you need to create. Enter a source data file value, the target member value, and name the rule. In this example, my source members are mapped to target members without modification using the like mapping type. When finished, save your entries. Now that I have all the components defined, I'll create my data load rule. This is where everything comes together. First, verify that you have the correct information selected in your point of view. Enter a data load rule name. Descriptions are optional. Select your category and import format. For source options, select the data file you previously uploaded. Save your data load rule. It's time to run the data load rule. When you select to execute the data load rule, you can choose only to run the import process or include to export to target. I'll start with the import process to verify that the data is staged correctly. The status column displays the current state of the import process. Click refresh until you see a check mark. Next, I'll navigate to the workbench. Verify that your point of view includes the correct location, period, category, and rule. The data is currently staged in data management. Notice the status icons displayed on the top of the page. Now, I'll run the data load rule and complete the export process. You can monitor the export process on the process details page. The export process is complete. I'll open rule balancing to verify the data load. The data was loaded successfully. What you see on the rule balancing page is the data loaded to the intersection of input and no rule, aggregated, which you can use as a checksum value against your source file. In this tutorial, you saw how to load a data file into Oracle Profitability and Cost Management Cloud using data management. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.